Good morning, welcome to Morning Outlook. This is Kim speaking on Thursday the 30th of April. So the US Fed meeting yesterday concluded that there was little else they were going to do at this stage. They've got tools to do things, but it was quite clear the emphasis was on the government to manage a lot of the funding, etc., of companies locally, by state by state. So they were pushing the burden of who does what, or making it clear who should be doing it, as opposed to the Fed itself. So quite clearly put there in their presentation last night. So little to be shown on the markets today from that meeting. The market just consolidated following it. But let's just have a look at the euro. Euro drifting up this week still. Still working its overall drift, pushing that way. You can see it a little bit clearer on this chart here. Higher lows still drifting through yesterday, just confirmed that really. It looked a bit soft and consolidated it in different phases, but managed to edge its way up through the Asian early session early on there. Sold off a little bit, but making up for that at the moment. We're back into Wednesday's highs here at this moment. We'll see where we come from that, but yeah, it's drifting to that upside, so it may be that retracements are still there to be bought. Okay, that's the euro dollar. Let's look at the pound. Okay, yesterday was certainly a day or two halves. Sold off from the morning through to midday-ish, and bounced right the way back. Solid buy back there. And again, really, the support was found eventually into the 4-hourly 50 there, around that sort of zone yesterday, as I say, midday-ish. And then it picked up for most of the afternoon there, pushing through. And, well, it's still keeping this more bullish view alive. It did put a lower high in yesterday, but that's now, as I say, it's turning and continuing that sort of drift to the upside. So completely convincing at times. There's the lower high that we saw quite clearly put in down to the 60-minute 200. And now, well, if it starts breaking down again, maybe it will. I'm looking at this alley. I'm sort of looking at a trend line, an invisible trend line on here across those lows there. If it starts breaking through, maybe below that daily pivot, we could see it pull back down towards its S1, maybe even back towards that 200. But the S1 with the 500 looks pretty interesting to me, around that sort of area, 124.10. It stalled there yesterday when it came down, but we'll see how it moves. But if this morning it can get a bit of a kicker, it's just, as I say, pulling back at the moment, but if it can get a bit of a kicker, maybe we'll see it pushing up towards the highs of, again, Wednesday's highs there. So we'll see how it develops this morning. But as I say, the drift is slightly to the upside here. A change may be just shown in terms of a break of that daily pivot. Right, that's the pound, the dollar yen. So dollar yen continued in its downward direction here. It's stalled a little bit this morning as I'm talking. It's sort of and it did slow up yesterday, and it was quite slow and not particularly. I mean, it pulled into its S3 there, weekly S3, and stalled there, bouncing around, stalling where it is. But it really is continuing in this route. It certainly seems like it's risked back on across these markets for now. I say, because I'm still considering whether they're I still believe that the US may come out of this quite quickly if they keep on piling money behind it and action behind it quicker than some of the other groups of countries such as Europe. Okay, bullish engulfing on the 60-minute here. Short term here, maybe we've got a move back in case it may push back to this early morning move there, the 1 o'clock move. We'll see how this develops. also just watch this 60-50 here. It starts turning here. Well, then I would consider looking at trading it back down towards that S1 area. But for now, although the trend is there, it might be at its end. The trend may be at its end. Look at that. Aussie dollar. So Aussie dollar has been my favorite in terms of trend-wise. It's not always given the best of pippage. But again, it's just where you see it on the 4-hourly, it's just continued. It's been a beautiful trend. Mostly it bounced off its pivots this morning. Yesterday it hovered around this area. I was looking at one stage, it looked like it was going to roll back towards that 60-minute 50. It was actually into its 30-minute 50 around this area. It held onto that and pushed up for the, as I say, and it's the rest is history. Not, as I say, massive movement, 25 pips ish, 26 pips, 27, maybe 30 to the highs. But retracement here back towards that 34, it's not been tested for a long time. Maybe that will give it yet another bounce. We are seeing a little bit of a retracement at the moment on these markets, and it's just a case of making a decision here. But the trend in this is such a decent trend. Okay, there may be some divergence running across the highs. I'm just looking at on this 60-minute time frame, so at some point we may see a bigger correction. But that 60-50 is probably calling out to be hit, and maybe that bigger correction that's needed just to give another shift to the upside. But the Aussie does continue to look pretty good there. The surprising one for me is the Canadian dollar continued, really. Fundamentally, I mean, with the it produces around about 5% of the world's oil, and you expect that to have some sort of knock-on effect economically, but it doesn't seem to be at the moment. Maybe because the US produces 18%, and you're comparing the two. So at this stage, it's sold off here, the dollar against the Canadian dollar, and its trend, the trend continues. Talking about this in the room yesterday, as much as I don't like it, and I think there's traders wanting to be long on this, I don't think it's now's the time, really. As people are getting a bit more risk back on and willing to risk things, these markets may and this currency may benefit for now. Any rally today up and towards that daily pivot may just give a point at this stage of a sell point. It's a nice area with the prior lows there, may set something up. So any rallies through this morning, that may be just the opportunity. Up until now, though, that 60-minute 21's been holding things pretty much in check. Didn't even get there this morning. Right, that's the Canadian dollar. That's pretty much done there. Look, I will have a look at oil because I'm covering this every day. I know there's a lot of people looking at when's it going to go up push. And well, we've seen the last 3 days it pushing up. Well, today being one of them, but it may roll over yet. It is edging its way there, and you'll see some half decent moves sort of coming through there. And if you bring it to the hourly, it certainly looks better. But it's not diverged here on this MACD. It does look a little bit softer on the RSI. Extremed back in here. Hasn't quite done it here. A bit softer, and at some point it may roll back again. Just watch out because, so there's only, I can't remember the date in May, so it's 19th or somewhere around there when we get the new contract in, and this may all go a bit pear-shaped again. So I know a lot of brokers are preparing themselves for that. In terms of their oil pricing, some of them are indexing it. So this would be, for example, 117. So if it goes negative, they can put that negativity in their systems. So be prepared, as they say. But at the moment, the oil is still pushing up quite comfortably there, as it looks. But there we go. That's that. And finally, the S&Ps. And again, solid push up yesterday in the end. The previous day, it struggled to get through. I was talking yesterday about it running up to its 61.8 where it's done that. And it's broken it and it's closed above it, which, could see a continuation of this move. It's bad, say, risk back on. There's companies in there that they're now supporting some of the drug companies. And all of this may just sort of push this market into a... send me full sense of security for now, and we'll see how this all develops as we get back into business nearer usual. I don't think business as usual will be there for some time, but as we get nearer this sort of thing and the results are looked at more closely. But for now, as I say, traders are looking where to put their money. They still think there's chances to make money on the stock markets, and big money's been pulling away from it lately. We'll see how it changes when we analyze this next Monday. Right, okay, for now though, divergence is actually sitting on the 60-minute daily pivot untouched for now. Could be a point if it starts put selling off as a target today, but later may become support. Okay, that's it for me. News-wise today, there's not a great deal out there, he says, quickly putting his finger on the button. Manufacturing PMI China, that came out already, 50.8 versus 51. That's amazing. It's still a positive figure. Anything over 50 is positive. Do sometimes wonder about the numbers, but who am I to question them? Euro monetary policy statement, so there's a meeting today at 12:45. We'll see that data coming out, and the press conference at 1:30 as normal. So it's all down to the ECB today to see what they're doing there. Again, last time they were actually suggesting states and countries should be putting into place their own action on this and not relying on interest rates and liquidity from the central banks. It'll be interesting to see if they strengthen those statements. Okay, that's pretty much it. I hope you have a great day. Watch out, there may be some volatility around that sort of more likely at 1:30 and 12:45 because there's no expected changes. So have a great day. Bye for now.